Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. I've come on today to show you how to make this lovely little Christmas gift box. I got lost then. So it's just a little reinforced box and the lid is also reinforced as well. And I've gone with that bow that I did on the really large gift bag the other day. But a smaller version of it, so I just really think it looks pretty. And that's it. So that's what we're going to make. I'm going to use a different paper pad. And again, it's another pad that I got from Every Crafts a Pound. And it's cold outside, so that's the pad. Some lovely papers in. As you can see, I'll give you a quick flip. So they're all blues and greys and white. So that's what I've gone with today. So I've pre-cut and scored everything just to make the video go a little bit quicker. For the base, I've just used a white piece of cardstock, and that needs to measure 8 inches by 11.5 inches, and you just want to score at 1/2 inch and 2 inches on all four sides. And then for the lid, that's 7 inches by 10.5 inches, and you want to score at 1/2 inch and 1.5 inches on all four sides, and that's just the back side of that. Then you're just going to want 3 strips. I've just done the length of the A4 paper, and I've used a silver foil paper. It's just 1/4 inch thick by the whole length of the paper. And that's just to go around the box. And then this one's 9.25 inches. And then this one is 6.75. But you're not going to need that much because it's for the bow. So we'll be chopping some of that off. Then for the actual bow, I've just took a grey piece of cardstock. And it measures 4.75 inches by 1.5 inches. And I've done it 1.5 inches to use with the Stampin' Up! Triple Banner Punch. Comes in 3 inch, 1/2 inch and 2 inch wide. Then you want 3... I've used white, which is 8.25 by 1.5 inches. And you want another one that's, 8.25, and then 7.5. Let me just have a look. Yeah, so one's 8, one's 7.5, and one's 7, all by 1.5. And then all I did with these is just took my bone folder and just encourage them to curl. So we'll do the bow after. At the minute, we want to just fold and burnish on all your score lines. So I'll quickly do that and then I'll come back. So I've just folded and burnished all the score lines. Then what you want to do is cut the ends. I've already gone ahead and done 2 of them just for quickness. And then you just want to repeat the opposite to the same. So cut down your squares and notch in, just the same as any box really, and then just cut down that other side and take out the small square and the rectangle, and then notch in on that top and take off that little bit off that tab, and then just repeat that on both sides. And then you just really want to do exactly the same on the lid as well. So what I'm going to do is pause the video, do that, and then come back. Okay, so that's what you should have. So I've just done one side of the lid. I'll come on and do the other side. So the 2 squares, you just want to cut up a notch, just the same as we did with the bottom. And then just chop off the rectangle and the small square, and then take off a little bit and notch. So again, once I've done this, I'll show you what you should have. Okay, just double check. There we go. So I'll just move all this out of the way. I know my last video was quite long, but I have had a lot of good response from it, so if you haven't watched it, do go over and watch that one. When you've cut everything off, just make sure you notch on these long edges. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we are going to put the box together. So I'm going to use wet glue. Depending on what wet glue you've got, sometimes it can warp the card a little bit, so you can use tape as well. But I'm just using glue because it's quicker for the video. So glue up all of your four tabs. Just a second, I'm going to use that other one. Sometimes the nozzles on these little glues get a little bit, I've just filled them up actually, just before the video. Okay. Right, so then what you want to do is, same as any box, fold in all the corners. And then that one as well. So I'm just going to hold that little second, and then you can go back in and burnish it once you've done. So then you want to do these two the same, just a minute. Sorry about that. Right, so you just want to do that. This is trouble when you've got the girls off, and I've got my dad here actually, and everybody decides to knock on your door. You see, my craft room is in my bedroom, so, and my bedroom's across from the living room, which is where Layla is watching, playing on her Spyro game. Right, so then when you've done that, the small tabs, the thin half an inch tabs, you just want to go ahead and glue those up and then fold them in, and that's going to reinforce your box. Then you really want to go, this is quite a thick card, so give that a good burnish down, and then go on then and do the rest of the corners. Okay, so I'll just hold that for a minute, and then just use my burn folder to go along, burnish that down, because it's such a thick card and I've just scored like a half an inch, it's kind of not, you know, it's pushing against. Go back over that one in a minute, doesn't want to stick. Okay, so next one. I need a bit more glue on that side. So let me just come off camera a second and just pop a little bit more glue in there, because it doesn't want to stick. There we go. Okay, so then we'll get the last one done. And just for the lid, you're just going to repeat the whole process again. So if you don't want to watch this, just skip through and get to the end of the lid. Right, so just holding that again, and then using your bone folder. I don't know if you can hear my girls there. So just go over and give it another good burnish with that. So that's the lid, and then repeat that on the box. What I'll do is pause it, do a little bit, and then I shall come back. Okay, so I've stuck the side flaps together and we're just on the long bits again. Okay. So just holding them down just to let that glue take, and then just give it a burnish then we'll do this one, and then just one more to go. So holding that one again. Last one, just holding that down just for a minute, and then burnish, and there we go. So I'm just going to go over all the four sides just to make sure they're nicely down, and then we can pop our lid onto our box. So that's a really nice snug fit and it is not going to come off. Okay, so that's your box, that's how it looks. Oops, zoom out a little bit. So we're just going to take the lid off and take that longest strip that you made and place it across the middle, wherever you think the middle is, and then holding that there, pinch it around your box. Okay, so then holding it on that side and just pinching it around your box. And then you're just going to stick that on. So what I'm going to do is just run a bead of glue all the way down it. And then find the middle and then just attach that back on. So there we go. And there we go. So then you can just turn it over and press that down. And then you want to just do the same across the side, so however far up you want that to be, hold it in the middle and press, hold it and press. I'm just going to cut a little bit off because it's a bit too long, and then what you can do is put your glue on again. So you're just making it look like a gift present, really, as if there's ribbon there, but there's not. So if you don't have ribbon, like I do have it, but not always for everything that I'm making, you can just make your own. You can make your own ribbon. So just pushing that on. And a lady did tell me that if you do get glue anywhere on it, then just let it dry and it will just buff back off. So not too worried about that. So there we go. And then that's your present. Then we're just going to make the bow. So there you go, it's all nice on the sides. And then we're just going to make the bow. So for your flag, you can use the banner punch or you can just make your own if you can make flags. So that will sit nicely across the top of there. And then what you want to do with all of your pieces is just run a bead of glue across the top and then bring in the other end and just hold it until, until it's stuck. Okay, if you did watch my video before, you'll see already how I made it, because I do show you on the other one. It's exactly the same process, it's just smaller. So just holding it there and then squeezing it until it's set. And then the last one, we're on 14 minutes. There we go. So once you've done that, take the first one, and where the join is in the middle, that's where I run the glue. So run your bead of glue, lay it down flat and kind of eyeball where you think the middle is, and just hold it there. And then once it's set, there we go, once it's set, it will kind of be that shape. So then you want to just come and do it to the other two. Same thing. So just hold it down again. And that will just sit there. And then for the last one, same again. And press that down, and that's how easy it is. And you could make these to any size you want, bigger. The other one on the other bag was 2 inches, which looked really nice for that bag because it was quite a large bag. Right, then you want to take your banner back, just apply glue to the bottom, and then, oh look, nearly put the wrong one. Make sure you get the biggest one. And then just eyeball where you think the middle is going to be. And then just press that on. Zoom in a little bit. Okay. So press that on, and then take in the next one and just lay that in the middle of that one. And then the last one in the middle of that one. Like that. And then we cut another 1/4 inch strip. Which is here. We're going to apply some glue to the back. And hold that over the middle of your bow. So holding that over the middle, then you can bend it around and then bend it around the back as well. And then you can just cut these ends off, apply some more glue. And then fold that back, and again cut the end off, pop some more glue on, and just fold that over the back. And then once you've done that, all that's left is to attach it to our box, like so. Zoom out. So, popping glue all over the back, and then if it doesn't sit, which it, I haven't had a problem yet, but if it doesn't, just use some hot glue. So I'll try and line it up with that strip, so I didn't quite do that on the last one. Just take the lid off. And you're probably really going to have to press that underneath. Like so. Okay. And then that should be fine. And then, there we go. There is our box with our little bow on it. So I really do hope you enjoyed that. I hope you'll give it a go. There's the one that we made before. And there's the silver and white. So I really do like how these turned out. Hope you give it a go. Please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you again for the next project. Bye!